I'm based in Mumbai. I'm self-employed over there. I work mainly for an international development charity, and I do quite a few things on their Moodle side.
Batao, why develop or
Moodle side? I can tell you later. Lately, I've been blogging
Camera?
About Moodle, so I've come to learn more about this amazing platform. After actually I've been using Moodle for more than 7 years, but it's only over the last few years that I've come to see the light of what is possible with Moodle. So here, I'm going to talk about how to create, at least my suggestions, on how to create a Moodle course that works for adult learners based on my experience. These are some of the courses I've developed and taught on Moodle. So I'm a teacher of scientific writing, so that's my kind of the subject I teach. But I've branched out into doing some other things, at least as a course creator. It's regularly even ran a MOOC recently. Just had more than 1,000 students from all over the world. And I continuously improve these courses. And I can never manage to convince my supervisors enough how much this is important, this continuous improvement. As you learn more and more about what is possible with Moodle, it's a course that you created 1 year back. If you've learned a lot more about Moodle, maybe you'll find that, okay, this is really outdated. I can use so many new activities. So that I try to do sometimes as part of my job, sometimes my free time. So that's my background. So the rest of this talk is going to be about my suggestions, which I hope will be of some use to you. So some initial questions to consider when you're planning a course for adult learners, I think, is, well, the first thing is, this part of a larger course or training program or purely online? And then is it self-paced or facilitated? And it's a course to be run on a schedule with start and end dates, like MOOC. Well, my experience is mainly with this purely online facilitated courses. I've done some blended training programs, but actually I don't work at a university or a school. It's really in the sort of tertiary education sector. So that's where I come from. So some points in designing an online course for adult learners. I think a good length is about 4 to 8 weeks. Shouldn't be too long or too short that people are, you know, by the time they get settled into the course is about to end. So 4 to 8 weeks, I think, is good. And study time, I think 2 to 5 hours is really, in my experience, what a lot of adult learners can devote. Even if a course is 2 weeks long, it can't be loaded with stuff to do. So just a little on the lighter side. And I think third point, I have to qualify this as if the course has people from different parts of the world, especially in synchronous activities, I think, are not a very good idea. Moodle does have a chat, and then with a big blue button, you can integrate video conferencing. But actually, I've not used all that because I find that already with the kinds of activities that we use on our Moodle, so sometimes learners are confused with that, then, you know, I don't want to have these synchronous stuff. So really, you know, to keep it on the simpler side. And making the course completion criteria, I think course induction, you know, that's really important. That's something I've learned over time, where sometimes the entire first week of a course is really about induction, and about explaining the different things in Moodle that you have used in the course. And sometimes they are self-evident, and sometimes they're not. So thinking through the course induction is important. Friendly, supportive environment that I can't emphasize enough. I'll get to that point a little later. Engaging content and activities, again, very easy to say, but how do we do that? I have some tips in a little while. So this is a screenshot of the course that I have developed and teach. It's a 6-week research writing course. It's writing research papers for... to avoid the stroll of death, where a course homepage becomes so long that only the teacher knows what's in there. The students are really overwhelmed at the outset. So I think single section, the one section per page format is good for most courses, I think. So course induction, so we make the completion criteria very clear, what learners have to do in order to complete the course and get a certificate. So this is the completion criteria that we used in our recent course. So we have weekly quizzes which learners have to pass. We also have peer assessment activities that we set up with the amazing workshop module. And also we kind of said you have to make a post in the discussion forum, which we didn't have said in hindsight because we ended up with more than 7,000 posts anyway because there were so many learners. So again, I think it depends on the course. You may not need to say that you have to make a post or make it a little more complicated than this. I wouldn't say the third criterion is you know, very well thought out. But just making clear is I think, really worked. It's very important for us. So teachers interface. So we use conditional access a lot to set when a particular section is going to be available. And sometimes in the course induction, we have a pre-assessment quiz. So those have to be completed for the sections to be available, the succeeding sections. So so the teacher's interface does look a bit cluttered. So the student's interface doesn't look as, you know, like this. Those messages disappear. So we have a sort of linear flow. We open up the course material section by section. It is not a self-paced course, so they have to go through it in a certain order. So one of the sections, so this is, we have a peer assessment activity on reflecting on research ethics, where they have to write an essay, which is goes into peer assessment the next week. A couple of lessons which I actually developed with a different open source tool called EXC Learning, which allows for standalone content to be created. I use the Moodle lesson module as well for another course, and a quiz. So there's a quiz as a pass mark. And the nice thing about pass mark, which I think now is a better user interface than the recent versions of Moodle, is you can set this more explicitly. I use 2.6, I have to kind of go into some settings to set the pass mark. So when a student passes the quiz, they get a green check mark, otherwise it's red. So this really works well. We've got really good feedback. Although, you know, the quiz itself isn't so great as a you know, collaborative learning activity, but it has really worked well for us. So some, you know, supporting reminders, some tips. The terminology we use in ASP where I work is facilitator. I think I saw that in Martin's slides as well. So I think that's a really good term to use in the context of you know, supportive environment for adult learners. And we call the learners participants. So just some basic things to begin with. Social forums and writing, because a lot of online facilitation is about writing. So really writing in a friendly way. I think Moodle emoticons is not something a lot of teachers use, but I think they are there, and they've been there for a very long time as far as I know. So you can really use those and make it more lively because you don't have that face-to-face, you can't smile at people otherwise, you know, as you can do in a face-to-face environment. And three parts of the participants, not students, not children. So participants by their names, so simple stuff. So a quick question here, how many types of activities can you build in a Moodle course? I'm sure many of you know, but who wants to go first? 10? 14, yeah, 14 is the right answer. So that's built-in activities, not the plugins. So just you know, screenshot from the Moodle website. I used, I think, about 11 of these so far. I'm not just use the SCORM external tool. Something else, but it really works well, and you know, I've just crashed the surface in using some of these activities. Like with quiz, I've done some more complex stuff over time, but something like database, I just barely just started using it. So there's a lot you can do, and I think that's the main thing about Moodle. You've got to know what Moodle can do, and then you know, map your requirements to that, and then see how far Moodle can support you in your requirements, and just starting with a blank sheet of paper. So learning what Moodle can do is, I'd say, really important. Now, content versus activities, just nearing the end of my talk. So, this is how I look at it. Content, course developers are concerned about content, especially even administrators, because content is seen as kind of property, as intellectual property or something that you create, that you show your worth in creating content. It's interesting, it's perhaps fulfilling. Learners find it boring to go through, there's just too much content out there. Activities, well, there are 14 types of activities, you know, and everyone can take quite a while for you to master to think about using it creatively. So it can be a little difficult to master those things. But for the learner, So I think that's a kind of paradox.